Actor Bill Murray is enjoying a renaissance. He has a new Netflix comedy special, and the New York Times recently declared him a pop culture icon. It turns out Murray is also a poet. And as special correspondent Francesca Maxime reports, he's found a home at New York City's Poets House.
I think we better split up.
Good idea.
Yeah, we can do more damage that way.
This is the Bill Murray we know. The actor, the comedian, the one who makes us laugh.
He slimed me.
But there's also the Bill Murray we aren't as familiar with, one who trades comedic lines for lines of poetry at a yearly benefit for Poets House.
What the Mirror Said by Lucille Clifton. Listen, you a wonder. You a city of a woman. You got a geography of your own. Listen, somebody need a map to understand you. Somebody need directions to move around you.
I used to be able to look in the mirror and see who's there, you know, who's there. And sometimes it's a reminder that there's no one there at all. There's not very much there. And sometimes there's someone that gives me confidence. And I feel that that poem is about someone who has an inner, you know, a self-confidence that's, you know, the bigger than, that can't be contained in the frame of a mirror.
Murray loves poetry so much, he wants to share some of that confidence with poets, writers, and readers. His support of Poets House, a nonprofit library and cultural center in New York City, has helped make classes and writing workshops like this one possible.
What we should be doing in the poem is like thinking about the way information is released at every step of the way throughout the poem. Now, how do we do that?
One way to do that, according to Poets House Executive Director Lee Bracetti, is having all kinds of poetry available to read for free under one roof.
It is really the National Poetry Collection. We have collected for the last 25 years absolutely comprehensively. You can walk in and have an experience that almost doesn't exist anymore, and especially doesn't exist for poetry.
Poets House sits along the waterfront in Lower Manhattan, boasting a 60,000-volume public library, exhibition space, reading room, and children's room. Every year, it collects and displays hundreds of books from publishers in its annual showcase, which assembles all American poetry published in one year in one place. Still, some critics argue that the location isn't gritty enough.
I have to say, we were worried ourselves, and it's more diverse. Our audiences have tripled. This is an affluent community, and so we really worked hard at making sure that our doors are open to everyone, that we really make sure that they're free class trips, and that we program in an incredibly diverse way that invites everyone in.
While Poets House offers many in-house programs, others take place out in the community. We went to their poetry walk across the Brooklyn Bridge this summer, which is how Bill Murray first encountered Poets House years ago.
While the poetry walk has been going on for 20 years, it keeps getting bigger and bigger every single year. This year, hundreds of people came out in order to hear Richard Blanco recite Walt Whitman's Crossing Brooklyn Ferry.
We love you. There is perfection in you also. You furnish your parts toward eternity, great or small. You finish your parts toward the soul.
At Poets House, Oscar-nominated and Pulitzer Prize-winning screenwriters and poets rub elbows with everyday visitors and fresh, creative writers like Aziza Barnes, who learned about Poets House from a friend.
I would start coming here, and I would always run into somebody I loved here, like, no matter what. And I was like, okay, I think this is a rich place.
Barnes became a Poets House Emerging Fellow in 2015. The fellowship included a stipend and writing workshops with some of the country's leading poets serving as mentors. There, she wrote the poem entitled Self-Portrait.
Only the turn of cement can arc black. I am blue damage, mother gut and tower. Truth, we are all for rent, red-lined systems. The door out is green and full.
What was it like being an emerging fellow with a bunch of other young poets here at Poets House?
I think it, especially in the class I was in, there's like not really that much of an interest in ego, in like, I'm a good poet because I wrote the thing that was published in the thing. It was more like, I'm here to be a student of this for the rest of my life.
Cultivating that lifelong learning is just what the Poets House co-founders sought. Stanley Kunitz, who is twice Poet Laureate of the United States, and Arts Administrator Elizabeth Cray, had a vision.
They felt that poets were lonely in this culture and needed a place to gather, to meet, to be nurtured.
Like other nonprofits, Poets House requires public and private financial support to keep its doors open.
A lot of the world would like to make you believe that the work you're doing is not important, will not change anything. Particularly the arts, but I think it's like the only thing that survives about culture for real, and like people do need it.
Including Cornelius Eady, a poet, professor, and co-founder of Cave Canem, a national organization for African American poets, which rented space from Poets House years ago to provide those writers with a safe place to create art and build community.
Validation is really one of the things that's so incredibly important. And that Poets House continuously sends out into the world as a message, you know, a great big yes.
What is poetry to you in a word?
I think it just gives me an opportunity to, hear some sort of voice of the soul, sort of the soul of a poet. It's all of our soul.
This one's by Billy Collins. It's called The Moon. And if you wanted to follow this example, tonight would be the night to carry some tiny creature outside and introduce him to the moon.
In New York, I'm Francesca Maxime for the PBS NewsHour.